The state's pandemics union has revealed a 20-year-old woman is among two people who died yesterday as ambulances faced lengthy delays. An investigation has been launched into whether the continuing ramping crisis is to blame.
As ambulances sat idle, two patients facing life and death trauma waited.
Incredibly long response times. One was in the order of 56 minutes, the other about 45 minutes, and both patients were deceased on arrival.
A 94-year-old woman went into cardiac arrest at 5:30 yesterday evening, less than 10 minutes from the Royal Adelaide, but died before an ambulance arrived. A short time later, a call was made to help a woman in her 20s suffering serious mental health issues, also living within 10 minutes of the hospital. It's unclear if she could have been saved if paramedics arrived on time. Neither should have waited more than 16 minutes.
My thoughts and condolences are with the family and friends of those two people who have passed. Obviously, there's a review which is underway at the moment. We'll wait for that result. We don't know whether the delay in getting ambulances there was a contributing factor.
It's not Premier Marshall, it's not Minister Wade that walks in and finds these people and then has to apologise to their families. It's our members, it's our paramedics on the road, and it's disgusting.
The union claim this is the fourth death caused by long delays in a week after two elderly patients died last Monday.
The opposition says 24-hour pharmacies could help ease pressure on hospital emergency departments, promising $900,000 to keep another three chemists across Adelaide open through the night.
It's not just about having more capacity in our hospitals, which is important. It's also about aiding people not needing to go to the hospital in the first place.
The health of the Premier's position as Liberal leader also called into question amid rumblings key independents will refuse to back him if Saturday's election produces a hung parliament.
I've heard speculation for a long period of time. I'm in my 10th year as the leader of the parliamentary Liberal Party.
Jodie Audie for 10 News First.